That's Oyinkan there. Oh, Oyinkan, you don't blow.
I would say there's a process.
Mm.
To an extent, I feel talk say I don't blow.
Well, you never blow like that.
Yes, we have the A list, we have the B list, we have the C list, so we have the D list.
So what list are you?
I would say C list.
C?
Yeah.
Ah, you need to move into A.
It's a process.
Do you need a Yahoo boy?
No.
No?
No.
Now let's look at this industry critically. What is the influence of Yahoo, the present Yahoo boys on this present industry? You got the point, you listened to Femi Falana's song,
yeah.
Fast, coming out to take on Nice, yeah. For encouraging crime.
Yeah.
Well, you know what, I will come in here, just, you know, as my colleague here said earlier, it's an economy. It's an economic situation, it's an industry, the music industry. And when you look at this as an industry, well, I won't really necessarily say government should fund it, just like they said, but I would say government should enable it. Enable it because there is no other, it's like the lowest hanging fruit if you are thinking of building a strong and viable small and medium enterprise ecosystem. Because, for example, there is no reason why a government cannot be part of maybe developing an international standard music festival, maybe in Ibadan, that can bring people from Lagos, bring people from Oshogbo, bring everybody here, get artists to get on the stage, perform, bring the big international media, and even what we do here can be seen in Chicago, can be seen in all.
What does that do to the local economy?
Because people will vend. There are vendors that will have to plug into that whole system to service that particular, the volume of people that will be coming into town. And you can see the economic impact will be huge because you're looking at hotels, you're looking at taxis, you're looking at restaurants, you're looking at all those things. And for imagine if Ibadan, for example, had two large-size international music festivals in this particular economy. Imagine what it would do to the ecosystem, the SME ecosystem.
Let's pitch this idea.
Yeah, we're already working on it. We created the recommendations recently, and we presented it through the Dawn Commission to the 6 state governors of the Southwest region.
And you are working on Amfest Expo.
Yes, the Amfest Expo project.
Tell me about it.
Well, it's more of like one of the things you want to do in an industry first is to get the practitioners in the industry ready for an economy that wants to happen. For example, it's a capacity building structure. It's a networking structure, and then it gives opportunity of showcase to the creative people within that industry. Because, for example, the music industry right now is blowing internationally.
Yeah,
it's a big wave, and it's a wave. It's a wave because, and what's a wave? A wave goes up and eventually comes down.
How much is it worth?
At the moment now, it has the capacity to be quite some $1 billion.
How much can we break in here within 4 years if we decided to build a solid entertainment
sector? For example, from the analysis that we did, which is from proper data starting from 2016, we can deliver most likely a 10 billion naira economic impact in 4 years.
We should be talking to Sheyi Makinde now.
Yeah.
Yes, that's the whole idea.
Sheyi.
Well, the question for me now is how much are we willing to invest? You understand? It's easy to start, you know, talking about figures, how much we can make, or you know, all the stuff. But it all starts from investing. And you have to invest right. Sometimes it's just about money. It's about knowing the right thing to do, the right places to invest, the right people to invest in.
Now, let's come back to the subject, Bacha.
Yeah.
Remember, it is the influence of Yahoo boys in this industry.
Yeah.
The first question is that where do they get the money from? Because I know they are influential from my own investigation.
Okay.
And I've asked some artists, I've been talking with them during the week, and they are clear that some of the artists are Yahoo boys.
Okay.
And you started by saying that these artists are mentors. People look up to them. Yeah. And if they live in crime, are they still mentors?
But I would say some of us are not into fraud.
A good number
of us. Like, I can state a good example with my own story. I studied music, which my dad at first was against it. And after studying music, I went on to represent the state at Project Fame. Do you understand?
Yeah.
And I came back, dropped some couple of hits. I dropped Adura featuring Olamide. And ever since then, I've been working. I didn't stop there. I studied political science in University of Abuja. I don't do music alone. I think artists need to understand that you can't push your materials just doing music alone. There are a lot of opportunities out there.
I'm sorry. Personally, I disagree with that.
Okay.
I've been in the art for a while. The art is very jealous. You cannot do music or movies with anything else. If you really think about it.
But you can improvise.
You can.
You can. But
it's a very jealous art. You have to put everything you have in it. That's why, like you said, there has to be an enabling environment. We're not even talking about...
Okay, I would like to ask... Sorry, I would like to ask a question. Is it every day that you do movies?
When you say every day, I've had a movie in the works for like... This is the second year running. It's not out yet.
What's happening to your movie?
Because I have to make it perfect. I want to make a good profit. I want it to go to the ends of the world. You know? It's like you want to build a skyscraper. You don't give it a three-bedroom foundation.
Yeah, I understand.
You understand?
Is that the life you live, just movie?
Yeah.
Because, you know, when you go and say, you can also be doing your Nollywood. You can run businesses.
You don't have to be there 100%. You can put people there.
I understand.
You can put people there.
Well, you know what? There's a new model for the entertainment professional right now, which is far different from what it used to be. The new model is that the entertainer now, or the professional, or the practitioner right now, has to be the businessman and be the content creator also.
Yeah.
And because you are the businessman and the content creator, you have to be a bit versatile. I'm not saying you have to go hustle something else, but even within the craft and the profession itself, there are layers to that. For example, I always tell somebody, we are coming up with something called Amfest Edu now. Amfest Edu means that we want to get to the secondary school level and then start to engage young people to understand what it is, the value chain of the entertainment industry, so that when they want to make a choice to go into that industry, they are not just campering around. Yeah. They figure it out and they go in. We will be bringing in mentors to come on that whole arrangement also. For example, how many artists have ever thought about, you know what, away from me creating music, is it possible for me to develop a school tour, a secondary school tour, where one way or the other, I as an artist, known artist, go around and eventually become part of the creative process for young students in secondary schools. And with that, I have maybe a retainership of maybe 100,000 naira per appearance. That is another stream of income that can come from you being an artist. But right now, any artist that is not thinking and going into the depth of the creative industry, as it were, right now, will most likely not survive. And as you said, I eventually need to lean on the Yahoo boy.
Yeah.
Okay. The lines are open. Join this conversation. Remember, I have Seun Sean Jimoh on the program. I have Oyinkansade Akande on the program too. And Kayode Adebayo is here.